tutorial, I'm going to go over the creation of a simple vessel, like something like a jug that you would use to hold liquid. And in doing that, we're going to take a look at the shell feature. So let's start by we'll do the jug the jug's body using a revolve. So we'll start by doing a sketch on the front plane here. Start a sketch. I'm going to draw my center line. And I'm actually going to do this as a series of revolves that are all created going together to create the same, a single solid body. So let me start just with the main body of the jug. So maybe something like this. I want the bottom of the jug to be flat, so I'm going to use a line for that part. And let's just adjust the shape of the sides here. Maybe something kind of like this. One thing that I should point out is when you're doing revolves, it can help for the top and bottom of the profile where they connect to the center line to be perpendicular so that you don't end up with points and depressions. Just to, as a way of illustrating that, let's assume that I go ahead with this sketch and I go ahead and do the revolve. It's a little hard to see, but there's kind of a point here because the profile wasn't going in at 90 degrees to the revolve axis. And similarly, if I were to let me get normal here. If I were to do something like this, you know, we end up with a depression there. The way to get it perfectly smooth at the two points where the profile connects with the center line, there's a couple ways to do that. The way I like to do it is to take the spline handle that is on one of these points, and now I'm selecting the handle itself, not the spline curve, but the handle itself, and I can actually give that a horizontal relation. So this way, no matter what, I can't move the spline handle up and down anymore, and the point at which the spline touches the center line here is going to be perpendicular. So if I've got something like that, then the top of the revolve is perfectly smooth. So that's just something to keep in mind. Okay, so this is maybe the body of the jug. Let's add another part here. I'm going to start a new sketch on my front plane. Again, I'm going to draw a center line, and this will be kind of for the spout. So maybe the top of the spout will be flat, and say I have a spline going down here. This part down here doesn't really matter because it's inside what we've already got in terms of a solid body, so it's just going to be merged in. And let me give this a little bit of curvature. Very slight. Okay, so I can revolve this as well. Oops, forgot to select the sketch first. Revolve this. Now, notice that I'm keeping merge result checked here. So what happens is that the new revolution is being included in the part of the solid body that we already had. So the result is I've got one single solid body. And then at the top here, let's just do, maybe I want a little lip there. So again, I'll go to the front. And start yet another sketch. This time, I'm going to use a construction line as my center line, and I'm just going to do a circle right here, and I'll revolve that around. Again, merge result is checked. I'm using the center line as my axis of revolution, and so that adds that as a lip. Okay. So maybe I would add a couple fillets now down here just to smooth that out a bit. So the problem with this vessel at this point is that it's a solid body. You can't put anything inside it. Just as a way to illustrate that, let's take a look at the section view, which you can see in View, Display, Section View. And what this allows you to do is to define a plane, in this case the front plane works just fine, that will chop your object through that plane. We've got some graphical corruption here. So it's not actually affecting my model, it's just that when I'm in this section view, I can see it, I can see the model chopped in half. So all this is solid material, and you can't put any liquid inside the vessel. So let me get out of my section view here. Okay. So we need a way to hollow this out, and we can do that through use of the shell tool. So I'm going to select my solid body, and I'm going to insert a shell feature. What I have to do is select a wall thickness, so I'm going to go with like 3 millimeters here, and show preview. It's a little bit hard to see, but what it's doing, let me just go ahead and, it looks like my thickness is too much given the size of the model. So, oops. Oh, actually, it has done it. It just was warning me. Okay, so it was just warning me that some of these details are going to go away because of the thickness of the shell feature, but it still succeeded. So what you can see is that it basically turned the outer skin of the body into a, it gave it a thickness, and everything that was inside that got hollowed out. Okay, but the problem is that we wanted our top to be open. So let me, again, turn my, whoops, that's perspective. I'll turn my section view off, and I'm going to edit my shell feature. And there's a place here where I can select faces to remove. So I'm going to select the top face here. And so that face will be removed. It will be not included in the shell, and it'll just be open instead. So if I do OK here, again, it's given me this warning. Now, that top face was not included in the shell. And if we again go to our section view, we can see that we have a working jug or vessel.